Hello everyone and welcome back to Balaji Online Classes. Once again, I Faizia Kidwai is here to illustrate chapter number 15, that is the stars and the solar system of class 8 science. Now, the vast space that basically includes the heavenly bodies including our earth is called as universe. And in this chapter, we are going to study about these heavenly bodies in a bit detail. First one is the moon. Now, moon is the natural satellite of our earth, right? And it is the brightest celestial body after the sun. Then, moon is almost 1/4 the size of the earth and there is no air or atmosphere found in the moon. Also, the surface of the moon is mountainous, means it has craters and also the soil is loose and hard. Then the moon takes approximately 27.3 days to complete one revolution around the earth. Then we also see different phases of the moon. Why it is so? Because the shape of the moon and the size of the moon keeps on changing. That's why we basically observe different phases of the moon. And the first phase is the full moon. When the rays of the sun directly falls on the moon, it is seen as a flat disk and this is called as full moon. Full moon basically is a purnima bhi kehte hai. Then we have the crescent moon. Now, when only a part of the moon is exposed to the sun, jab ek hi part pe moon ke sun ki roshni padti hai, then we only see that part of the moon and that is known as crescent moon. Then we have the new moon. Now, when the earth and the sun are on two opposite sides of the moon, then moon appears completely dark. Mean as a result, we cannot see the moon. And this is the new moon day and this is also called as Amavasya. Then we have the stars. Now, stars are huge heavenly bodies which are extremely hot and due to the heat, they also start twinkling and we see that stars are twinkling in the sky. Stars ek light emit karte hain jo basically us heat aur us jo energy unke andar hoti, jo heat hoti, jo light hoti, wo hoti hai aur usse kya hota hai, hame stars basically visible hote hain, right? The light emitted by them makes them visible. Then they are usually much bigger than the earth. वो earth के size से बहुत ज़्यादा हैं, but चूंकि वो इतने distance पे हैं, इसलिए हमें बहुत छोटे-छोटे से stars दिखाई देते हैं, right? Sun is also a star, but चूंकि sun जो है वो earth के बहुत पास है, इसलिए हमें sun इतना बड़ा और इतना bright दिखाई देता है. Then the next nearest star is Alpha Centauri, which is about 4.3 light years away from the earth. Then we have constellations. अब क्या होता है जो stars होते हैं, they basically appear in an arranged pattern. ठीक है, एक proper arranged pattern में ये पाए जाते हैं and this is called as constellation. Then we have some major important constellations. First is your Ursa Major. This constellation consists of 7 bright stars which are arranged in a form of Dipper. And Ursa Major is also called as Great Bear or Sapt Rishi. Then we have Ursa Minor. Ursa Minor also has 7 bright stars which are arranged in a form of that resembles a bear. A bear resemble karta and this is also called as Little Bear. Then we have the Orion. This constellation also has 7 bright stars and few faint ones. Kuch bahut dim se hote hain stars isme. To is tarah se apne aap ko arrange karte hain ki hame lagta hai jaise ek hunter ki picture hai, right? And its name in Indian astronomy is Vyada or Mirga. Then we have Cassiopeia. It is another permanent constellation in the northern sky which is visible during the winter in the early part of the night and it looks like a distorted letter W or M. Ya to ye W ke shape ka lagta hai ya to M ke shape ka lagta hai. Distorted means bikhra hua sa, right? And its name in Indian astronomy is Sarmishtha. It is also a group of 5 stars. Then we have the solar system. Now, solar system is what? Solar system basically is a collective term that actually consists the sun, 8 planets and also we have other heavenly bodies such as comets, meteoroids, moon which basically revolve around the sun. Then, sabse pehle sun head of the family hota hai solar system mein, right? Sun jo hai wo closest hai earth ke. We already have discussed this and gases like hydrogen and helium produce heat and light in the sun. Then we have the planets. There are total number of planets are 8. First one is the Mercury. Mercury ko kehte hain hum budh grah, right? So it is the first and the nearest planet, that is nearest to the sun. Being closest to the sun, it is very hot during the day and extremely cold during the night. Night ke time pe jab sun ki roshni nahi milti, then this planet becomes extremely cold. Or of course, it has many craters on its surface and it has no satellite of its own. Then we have the Venus. Venus ko hum kehte hain Shukra grah, right? It is the second planet from the sun and the closest to the earth. It is hotter than Mercury and it is also called as evening star. Why? Because it basically appears in the west after the sunset. सन के डूब जाने के बाद वेस्ट में ये दिखता है, इसलिए इसको इवनिंग स्टार कहते हैं और इसको मॉर्निंग स्टार भी कहते हैं क्योंकि ये ईस्ट के साइड में सन के अपियर होने से पहले यानी कि सनराइज से पहले दिखाई देता है, राइट? देन वी हैव द अर्थ और यू कैन से पृथ्वी. इट इज द थर्ड प्लैनेट एंड ओनली प्लैनेट वेयर लाइफ एग्जिस्ट. नाउ इट बेसिकली डू रोटेशन ऑन इट्स एक्सिस एंड ऑल्सो रिवॉल्यूशन अराउंड द सन. Then we have the Mars or the Mangal grah. It is the fourth planet from the sun and often visible as a red object in the sky. इसको red color होने की वजह से इसको हम red planet भी कहते हैं. Then we have the Jupiter or we can say Brihaspati, fifth planet and this is the largest planet of our solar system, right? It has a very thick atmosphere that surrounding it and it also has a faint ring. एक चारों तरफ इसकी एक faint सी ring होती है और इसके 39 moons होते हैं. Then we have Saturn or you can say Shani. It is the sixth planet from the sun and size is almost the same as that of the Jupiter. इसका almost size जो होता है वो Jupiter से resemble करता है, same ही होता है. इसमें 7 beautiful flat rings होते हैं जो कहा जाता है कि बर्फ से बनी होती है, right? Then इसका temperature बहुत ज़्यादा low होता है. Then we have the Uranus or we can say Arun grah. It is the seventh planet from the sun and it is the largest planet which is very far from the sun and it appears greenish in color. Its color is green, right? And here the temperature is so low, that's why here life is not possible. Then we have Neptune. Neptune is the eighth planet from the sun and it is also very cold like the Uranus. Then we have the other members of our solar system. इसमें पहला है हमारे एस्टेरॉइड्स. एस्टेरॉइड्स क्या होते हैं? बेसिकली रॉक पीसेस होते हैं दैट बेसिकली रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन बिटवीन द ऑर्बिट्स ऑफ मार्स एंड जुपिटर. मार्स और जुपिटर के बीच में जो ऑर्बिट होता है, जो स्पेस होता है, वहां पर ये पाए जाते हैं और ये सन के चारों ओर चक्कर लगाते हैं. दे आर नियरली 1,00,000. द लार्जेस्ट वन इज द सिरस. और एस्टेरॉइड्स का ये कहा जाता है कि बहुत पहले बहुत बड़े बड़े प्लैनेट्स होते थे तो ड्यू टू सम फोर्सेस और सम अदर नेचुरल रीजंस क्या हुआ कि वो ब्रेक हो गए और ब्रेक होकर छोटे छोटे पार्टिकल्स में कन्वर्ट हो गए. तो बेसिकली एस्टेरॉइड्स आर दोस पार्टिकल्स ओनली, राइट? देन वी हैव द कॉमेट्स. कॉमेट्स आर द हेवनली बॉडीज दैट रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन एंड बहुत लार्ज ऑर्बिट में रिवॉल्व करती है, राइट? कॉमेट इज बेसिकली अ लार्ज लूज कलेक्शन ऑफ मटेरियल्स एंड अपियर एज अ ब्राइट ग्लोइंग बॉल विद अ लॉन्ग ग्लोइंग टेल. इनकी जो टेल होती है वो भी बहुत ग्लो करती है. जो टेल बेसिकली आपके डस्ट और गैसेस से बनी होती है, राइट? वन सच कॉमेट इज हेली कॉमेट विच अपियर्स वन आफ्टर द 76 ईयर्स. और लास्ट सीन कब दिखा था हमें लास्ट टाइम? ये लास्ट टाइम हमें ये 1986 में दिखा था. Then we have the meteors or meteoroids. जो meteors होते हैं वो small heavenly bodies होते हैं या कह सकते हो छोटे छोटे टुकड़े होते हैं पत्थरों के, metallic rocks के, जो basically बहुत ही high speed पे travel करते हैं space में, right? And when meteoroid enter the earth surface, it gets heated up and becomes visible. और जब ये अर्थ में एंटर करते हैं अर्थ के एटमोसफेयर में तो कुछ ऐसा पार्ट इनका होता है जो हीट अप नहीं करता है, जो बर्न अप नहीं करता है, और वो क्या करता है? वो गिर जाता है. और जब वो गिरता है वो पार्ट, तो उस पार्ट को हम कह देते हैं मेटेरॉइड, राइट? देन वी हैव द आर्टिफिशियल सैटेलाइट्स. नाउ जो मैन मेड सैटेलाइट्स होती हैं, जो मैन मेड सर्कुलेटिंग ऑब्जेक्ट होते हैं या जैसे कि प्लैनेट होते हैं जो बेसिकली अर्थ जाके स्पेस में फिक्स किए जाते हैं, उसे हम बोलते हैं आर्टिफिशियल सैटेलाइट्स. जो पहली आर्टिफिशियल सैटेलाइट थी वॉज पुंतिक 1, विच वॉज लॉन्च्ड ऑन 4 अक्टूबर 1957 बाई USSR. Then the first Indian satellite is the Aryabhatta, which was launched on 19th April 1975. और उसके बाद से इंडिया ने बहुत सारी satellites launch की. Then we also have certain uses of satellites. Artificial satellites के जो uses होते हैं, वो ये होता है कि वेदर फोरकास्टिंग में ये हेल्प करते हैं, ठीक है, सेटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन में हेल्प करते हैं, रेडियो एंड टेलीविजन ट्रांसमिशन में हेल्प करते हैं, ऑल्सो फॉर लोकेटिंग मिनरल रिसोर्सेज अंडरग्राउंड वाटर एंड लैंड मैपिंग, देन इट ऑल्सो हेल्प इन कलेक्टिंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट अदर प्लांट्स. So with this note, the chapter has been ended, class. Now please read this chapter thoroughly. Learn all the difficult terms along with their meanings and spellings. You can get the notes of this chapter through School Mitra app. Kindly download those PDFs and complete your work. Thank you. Stay home and stay safe.